Alright, hello everyone and welcome back to Kotobo Space Program, where today we are having a look at the Field Training Facility mod, which was originally made by forum user E4. It's now being maintained by Zero Kerbal. And what this glorious little piece of work looks to add into the game is a nice alternative way of training your Kerbals by allowing them to passively train inside of a module, which is pretty cool, not only because it's always nice getting better trained Kerbals, but also I just personally always do enjoy having an alternative way of doing anything really inside of my video games. So let's talk about how it works, and to start we're going to have to jump into the vehicle assembly building to take a look at the part where your Kerbals will actually be training inside of. And it's a vanilla part in science, and that is the mobile processing lab, which, I mean, overall hasn't really been changed. It serves the same function as it always has with all the sciencey things, but if we go to the attributes, you can see we have a new one added here called Field Training Facility. And what this will do is, so long as there are Kerbals inside of this, you can train them using time and electric charge. And it's gonna take a lot of time to train them. We'll talk about that more when we're outside. The electric charge, though, is a bit more quantifiable, as well, it's going to take 4 electric charge per second per Kerbal. So if you have both seats in the mobile processing lab filled with a Kerbal, that means you'll take 8 electric charge per second for them to train. And if you run out of any power and, you know, your whole ship's without it, they'll pause training because, well, with no power, they have nothing to do. But, I mean, 8 electric charge per second, though quite a bit, isn't insurmountable. It's actually fairly easily attainable. Just make sure that you have enough battery power over any, say, if you're on a planet, any of your knights on there, or else, yeah, your training will get paused. So let's actually head out to the launch pad with a craft I built earlier, the Field Training Facility ship, and remember to load it with Kerbals. There we go. Let's grab Bob and Valentina and head out to the launch pad and take a look at how this works. And it's pretty simple, really. I mean, if we do, once loaded, right-click on the mobile processing lab, you'll see we have a new little option here just above all the buttons called Training Facility. And if we click that, it expands out, and we have a couple of things here. The first is the training status, currently false. We then have the current Kerbals, Bob and Valentina, with their levels both being 0, and the percentage that their training has progressed, currently at 0. And if we want to start training, we just simply hit the start training button, and there we go. They're gonna start training. And if we actually open up our resource panel here, you can see we are currently using power. Now, we're not currently draining 8 because, well, I do have some solar panels on here providing a little bit of electricity, but we are still draining power. And once that runs out, like I said, they will stop training. But yeah, again, it's not that hard to get all the power. If I just unfurl both of these XL solar arrays, that is actually more than enough to keep them training and recharge our batteries, so it's not too bad overall. Again, just make sure you have enough batteries for those long, cold nights. Now, as you can see here, if I go back to right-click and expand out, in the time I've been talking, it's gotten 0.02%. It takes a while. In fact, to get from level 0 to level 1 in total is gonna take, I believe, about 13 days. And if you want to get them all the way up to level 5, it's gonna take about a year. Now, you can hurry that along. Those numbers are based off of being here on our planet. But if you're up in orbit, it's actually gonna go 4 times more quickly because they're actually on a mission out there somewhere doing more important things, so training happens more quickly. And even better, if you're on another celestial body, say, you know, Duna, then the training is actually gonna happen 6 times more quickly. So it really does encourage you to send up your Kerbals to more far-flung places to train, and all in all, actually give your Kerbals something to do. That's why I actually really like this mod, because, well, in this game, your Kerbals are just typically sitting inside of their pods here, doing nothing. And if they're on, say, a deep space mission to Joule, they're gonna be doing nothing in there for a very long time. Why not have them training and earning some levels to become more experienced, better Kerbals? And it just makes sense to me and seems a bit more realistic. Now, if you don't like the amount of time it does take, there is another alternative for you. On the exact same mod page that I'm, of course, linking to in this video for the Field Training Facility, there is a second mod on there called the Field Training Lab, which rather than using time and electric charge, just uses science. And if I'm remembering correctly, it's 20 science per experience level, or a point of experience, rather. And so it's an alternative way, but here's the reason I prefer this one. The science-based one is instant. Once you have 20 science, you click the training button and they immediately have that point of experience. In this, it takes time. It's giving your Kerbals something to do on those long missions rather than being an instantaneous button click, which I feel could be quite easily gamed to, basically make some sort of experience farm for your Kerbals. This way, again, it's just time and electric charge. Granted, you still could just build a giant space station in orbit where they will train four times more quickly and have the entire thing made up of like 20 mobile processing labs, but still, it's at least still taking some form of time and effort. And yeah, overall, I think it's a fun little mod. I very do much like this Field Training Facility, as again, it gives your Kerbal something to do to make them better. But let's actually just sort of move forward time here and show you how long it'll take for them to get to that just level one. Now we're almost up to 10%. You can see at night when our battery gets low, the training actually does slow down, but during the day when it has full power, it's going pretty quickly there, and we're almost to 50% after however many days it's been. Again, it takes a while. Your Kerbals, you know, they take a lot of effort to get better, and we almost have it, and let's slow down right about now. There we go. We get a little warning. First training complete. Bob and Valentina are now both level one. And if we actually go to revert flight, you can see it took us that 13 days to do. And again, here on the planet, that's how slow it'll go. If you go up into orbit or another planet, it'll be quite a bit more quick. But yeah, that's really all there is to talk about with this lovely little mod. So if you'd like to check it out for yourself, and perhaps if you would like the Field Training Lab one instead, you can have a look at the link in the description of this video. And actually, one more thing to mention, the mod maker, or rather Zero Kerbal, currently maintaining the mod, may combine the two in the future. That is a possibility. But for right now, you can have either of them installed, or in fact, both of them. They aren't mutually exclusive. You could train them over time and then when you got a lot of science, go click, click, click with the other to spend that science. So you can do it however you like. But yeah, that's gonna be it for today. I hope y'all have enjoyed this video and that you do come back for the next, when hopefully we'll be looking at yet another wonderful mod. But until that time, thank you for watching, and as always, have a good one!